Hello everyone, it's John, W5CYF. Welcome to my ham shack. Today I want to address a question that occasionally comes up in my comment section, and also I see it often on the forums, and that is, how do you bring your coax from the outside into your ham shack? And there's many ways to do that. You can bring it down through the attic. You can bring it through. Some people put dryer vents in their wall. If you have pier and beam construction, you can bring it up from the back or from the bottom of the floor. What I'm going to show you is what I did here, and that is the way that I made a pass-through for the bottom of the window. It's all homemade, and it did not cost a whole lot of money. And it works really well, and I'll show you what I did to make mine. And by the way, I've had it in use for nearly a year. And the reason I'm going to make this video is I'm going to change the way the grounding passes through the window. And I'll have a separate video about how I grounded the station, the RF ground, and I'll put that on a separate video here as soon as I get this part built. And I'm going to have to tear the shack down here on the desk to do the second part. But anyway, come follow along, and I'll just take you on a brief sort of show and tell as how I built the window pass-through. Okay, I'm back in the shack, and let me just show you what I've got here. This is the pass-through board, and this is the interior side. I've just got four coax connectors coming through, little barrel connectors. You can see how they are right here. And on this side right here is just a piece of printed circuit board. And of course, it's got the weather stripping along the side and also on the ends here. Now, this board here is a pine board. It was number one pine, and I just put house paint on it. And again, this is the board that's been out there for about 2 years in the window. I'll show you here when it gets in the window again. But it's held up very well. I'm just going today and actually putting another ground screw so I can carry my station ground outside to the common ground. So I thought I would just make a video and kind of show you a little bit about what I've got. If you notice the back side of it here, I've just got washers. And as you probably know, I've got a little small machine shop. And I was able to machine the inside diameter of the washer out. But you can do the same thing with a round file and get the same results. Now the next thing I'm going to do is just put a 1032 stainless steel bolt through here, a little machine screw, and then I'm going to take the station ground here and I'm going to push it through to the other side over here. So I've got one more thing to do and then I'll show you the completed thing. Well, actually, I'll just go ahead and show you now. Before I put it together, I use this ox guard. You can buy this at Lowe's. And it just helps prevent some of the oxidation along the outside. But this PC board here has been outside now for 2 years and is working just fine. So here's the completed job from the outside. You can see where the ground is off to the right hand side of the screen, and the ground runs down to a ground rod that goes into the ground, and then off from there it goes over to the electrical ground, so everything has got a common ground on the house. And of course it just goes all the way over to the other side of the window like that, and you'll see that. Now of course it does have insulation along the ends, and it does have that weather stripping along the top and bottom. Now again, I've used this for about 2 years, and you can put your hand up to it and there's no air that's passing through it if you use a good job of insulating. Well, that's looking at the inside of the completed job. And as you see, I only have four coaxes coming through, but you can put anything that you want to in there. The wire off to the left, and that's going to be my station ground. That's going to take the ground from the equipment, and I'll run it outside also. You can see the weather stripping across the top. You probably can't see the side that's over there. And now you'll also need to put something in to lock this window right here, because it is away from the bottom by about 4 inches. You'll need to put a lock, and you can get those locks, and they're just little screws that you put on your window to do that, and that way you'll have your security alarm working, as well as making sure that no one can get in the window. Well, I hope you got an idea or two off that and see how inexpensive and easy it is to go ahead and do a pass-through window for your coax. And also, even though I didn't have it on mine, as you know, you can also go ahead and put in connectors for pass-through wires if you wanted to, for balanced line, end fed, long wire, or whatever. Use the printed circuit board and just drill your holes and continue to use the same concept that I was using there. Well, I hope to catch you on the air, and until next time, 73.